Hey everyone, I'm Avery from the O1 Labs team working on Coda, and I'm here to tell you about our GraphQL API. So if you've been running a daemon up to this point, you can just keep doing that as usual. And basically, there will already be an endpoint where you can access the GraphQL server at localhost 3085/GraphQL. If you need help setting up your daemon, check out our docs or ask on our Discord channel. So you might ask, what's GraphQL? And that's a fair question. It's sort of like a REST endpoint, except a little bit more flexible in the types of things that you can query from it. You can specify exactly the fields that you want to get, and it's actually pretty nice to use. So this is GraphQL. It's a tool that you can get by going to that localhost address on your node. Basically, it lets you click around, getting all sorts of cool information about the node and the network, and easily query it. For now, we're going to get some information about the snark pool. So we want to get like the fees of all the snarks. So we can do that by just clicking snark pool fee. It makes this query, and then we get the data. So that's really easy. We're going to run a node app right now, so I'm going to copy paste this. But you can use any language you want. Just Google for GraphQL client library. So I'm going to just paste this in to my editor right now and save it down as something called challenge.js. Since this is a node project, I'm going to create a quick node project here with just some default values. So we have a package.json. And that lets us follow these instructions here, which is basically to add this string here to our package.json dependencies, like that. So I'll save that, and I need a comma right there. And then I'll just npm install, which will bring in node fetch, just make it a little bit easier for us to make some requests. Since this is a node project, and I don't want to deal with ES6 imports, I'm just going to do var fetch equals require node fetch instead. It's the same thing. And then here I'm going to add a header so that the server will know that we're expecting JSON. Content type application JSON. And so basically, if I save that and then run node challenge.js, we'll see if that works. And yeah, it looks like we got a bunch of fees. So that's pretty neat. And we also got the version. So you can see this is an object with a version and a snark pool, which has an array of objects that have a bunch of fees in it, which mirrors basically the structure of the query that we gave. So it's, you can pretty much customize exactly what you're getting back. And right here, we can see that we can do something great with this data. And so maybe let's start with just getting the data that we care about. So like this fee number, and like, let's see what we can do with that. So let's take the data and do, we want to map over data.snarkpool. And then this is going to be the fee, so we want to do .fee. We can save that and try running it again, see what we get. So that's giving us just the numbers, which is cool. We want them as some integers, maybe, so that we can do math with them. So I'm going to just parse int them and run that again. Cool, so now they're just ints. Now I'm going to save this as, you know, some variable called numbers, maybe. And we can see, you know, can we get the minimum of this thing? So it turns out there's a cool trick you can do. Math.min, and then you pass in all the numbers. You sort of spread that array in as arguments. And that should give us the minimum. So let's just say, make a little thing that says like min snark fee. And then let's see if that works. So it looks like the min snark fee is 1. I mean, that's not really a surprise, judging by the data. So that looks about right. That's good. I guess we could also have the max snark fee. This is sort of useful if maybe you want to figure out how high of a fee to set your snark worker at. It's obviously a really simple example, and we're doing other, you know, more complex things with this API. Like we're building, you know, a wallet, and we have a bot that runs using it, and several sort of network visualization tools that people have worked on. And so you should really use your creativity with this. And now's the perfect time to build a cool tool on top of Coda. because it's the winter special until January 13th, which means that you can win an NVIDIA 2080 Ti graphics card. If you build something, share it on our forum. We're really excited to see what you make.